Hey guys, Corbin here, and I want to talk about setting up an automatic tool changer, or ATC, on my Avid CNC. So why did I get one? It's because of this. Yeah, that's like a 2-second tool change, and I don't have to reset my Z. But of course, the machine can automatically do it for me. In this video, I'm going to talk about some spindle options. Next, I'm going to talk about my air setup, since it's required. After that, I'll cover my pneumatic setup, going over some diagrams on how it's done. And finally, I'll discuss what wires go where in the Avid control box. And feel free to skip ahead to whatever chapter you're interested in. The markers will be down below. So first of all, what did I get? I got a HITECO QD-1F spindle, which is rated at about 6 horsepower or 4.5 kilowatts. This is the biggest ATC that you can fit on Avid's gantry without exceeding their weight recommendations. With the paired VFD on single phase, it really puts out about 5 horsepower. I bought this as a kit from CNC Depot, which also makes their own ATC spindles, in particular one called the S30C that a lot of people use on their Avid CNC machines. That spindle only puts out around 3 horsepower, and if I were to do it again, I would probably get the S30C because I'm not really sure I need 5 horsepower. 5 horsepower might be good for chewing through lots of big pieces of wood with, say, a 2-inch bit at fast rates and fast depth of cuts, and those just aren't the type of thing I really plan on doing a lot. So I'm going to talk about how I wired up my HITECO spindle, but I'm going to also talk about the S30C spindle because it's very similar, and I'll note differences as I go. The automatic drawbar runs on air pressure. You have to have about 100 psi, and it has to be clean and dry. So I have a really basic compressor, but it works pretty well for what I need, and it's a 135 max psi. I have it set to deliver about 100 to 110 psi from the main regulator. Right off the main regulator, I have one filter to catch water, a water separator. The interesting thing about how you should actually plumb these, you can use this aluminum clad plastic plumbing pipe that I'll link to in the description to deliver it to wherever you need it. And what I did, all the runs from the compressor tend to go downhill, and at the end of the run I have a drain, and that way all the water will try to go into that location. The other thing I did is the drop for the CNC machine, the pipe goes up and then back down. And this really helps. I do not get hardly any moisture inside of my air that delivers it to the CNC machine. So from the air tubing coming off the wall, I have first a water separator. This gets rid of the majority of the water. And then after that, I have some beads that will make the air dry. And they tend to turn pink after they absorb a lot of moisture. I have a shutoff valve so I can turn off the air to the machine really easily. And then just the tubing that runs over to it. Okay, let's take a look at the HITECO spindle and see what it has on it. So it has the main power supply, which it came with this wire. It has a second input wire, which for me, I use the Cat5 cable. It is shielded because you don't want any noise to happen in it. All this cable really has is it has access to the switch. So it sends a voltage through the switch, and then the switch completes the voltage, which goes back out. And that tells the relay to open up the air to have this button work on the side. The S30C does not have a button like this, but you could easily wire one up. I'll find one and link to it in the description, include a wiring diagram, how you could add your own. Super handy to have a button on your spindle to change it. Next, we have the air inputs. And so we have the main air input right here, which is tool release on mine. And so the tool release, what happens is there is a relay down in the control box, and when Mach 4 or this button is hit, the relay is powered. That powers the air, or it gives it air, and then the air goes through, which makes the spindle open. When the relay turns off, the air goes out and the spindle closes. This one also has tool lock pressure air that it needs. The S30C spindle does not need that, so it doesn't have this other one. It only has two air hoses. So the last air hose on the S30C and on mine is for case pressurization. And so case pressurization should always be on when the spindle is on. And what that does is basically it keeps the bearings clear of any dust, or at least that's my understanding. One of the nice things about this particular spindle is when the air is pressurized to release the spindle, it has a whole bunch of air coming out, which will help get any chips off of the tool when it's going to actually load another tool. This is the setup for my drawbar pressure, which is the only required part of the project. The source air comes in at 110 psi, which first goes into a small distribution block. That goes into a regulator that sets the required pressure for the drawbar. The air goes into a solenoid, which is controlled by the drawbar relay. The air is constantly fed through output A. For the HITECO, this goes into the tool lock input. For the S30C, it goes into case pressurization. On the S30C, this is the air that you hear constantly running through the spindle. Output B is opened up when the relay is activated. This opens the drawbar. The input for the relay is controlled by a 5-volt pin on the Avid control board, which I'll discuss in a bit. The relay takes power from a 24-volt DC supply and gives it to the solenoid when activated. This means it's easy to add a push button to activate the solenoid by taking the power from the 24-volt DC supply and wiring it to a momentary button. When you push the button, the solenoid will be powered and will open the drawbar while you hold the button down. The HITECO requires a separate case pressurization line set at a lower pressure. So I ran a line from the distribution block to another regulator set somewhere between 8 to 10 psi. This goes to a basic on-off solenoid. When it's on, air is supplied to the case pressurization line. The solenoid is controlled by a case pressurization relay controlled through Mach 4. I activate the signal when the spindle is turned on and turn it off when the spindle is turned off. The relay provides power to the solenoid from the 24-volt DC power supply. I also tap off this power to turn the spindle fan on so it isn't constantly running whenever the control box is powered on. The S30C doesn't have a fan, so this won't apply to that spindle. I'm not sure if the S30C could have its case pressurization line turned on and off via relay. The spindle might require the air to close the drawbar. If someone knows about this, comment in the comments and I'll update the description about it. I have another basic set to provide air coolant. This is just another hose that's wired up in a similar way as the last setup, and it can be controlled by another Mach 4 output. I'm not actually using this yet, so this is just in theory. The next diagram is for checking the air pressure. This isn't required, but it's really important to ensure your air is on before a tool change happens. Otherwise, the tool won't release and you could just pull the tool fork out or bend the rack or break something. I use the same distribution block as before and have a pneumatic pressure switch connected to it. The switch has a hex bolt on the top that lets you adjust what pressure it activates. I'll discuss how I set it up in a later video. The wires from the pressure switch will go to the future input signal 8 on the Avid control board. One thing that I'm leaving off are all the hose interconnects. For the S30C, you're going to need a handful of quarter-inch tubing push connects that go to quarter-inch male pipe thread or some that go to eighth-inch male pipe thread, depending on which fitting they go into. For the HITECO, you will also need some 6mm and 4mm connects because that's what tubing it uses. I'll put links in the description on what I bought and from where. Now on to wiring the Avid control box. I'm following the directions from CNC Depot and I'll put a link to theirs in the description, but I am going to add some extra stuff. This is my Avid control box and the two relays are going to get wired up right here on these outputs. This is the schematic for the red breakout board. The part to look at is at the top left here. The drawbar control signal goes to the drawbar relay. The positive red wire from the relay goes to the terminal 23. The black wire goes to terminal 24. These overwrite the motor 6 outputs, which generally aren't used. The case pressurization signal goes to the case pressurization relay. The positive red wire from the relay goes to terminal 25. And the black negative wire from the relay goes to terminal 26. The air pressure check wires go into one of the future input signals. I use the one on the bottom right behind this green terminal. Here it is highlighted on the schematic board. The air pressure check wires go into future input signal FF8. The wire order doesn't really matter, but for consistency, put the red wire on terminal 1 and the black wire on terminal 2. So this covers the basic hardware setup for the ATC. Once you have it wired up, you should be able to push the manual button on the spindle and perform quick manual tool changes. In the next video, I'm going to discuss making the ATC tool rack and how I made one for free out of scrap wood. After that, I'll have a video discussing how to set everything up in Mach 4. Thanks, everyone.